Hi doctor, could you please explain what are the different types of breast cancer?
Breast cancer can arise from various components of breast. It could be the duct, or a duct is a thing which conveys the milk from the lobules or the glands from where it is formed to the nipple. So the cancer can form in the duct, which is the most common form of cancer, which is called as ductal carcinoma. It can be in the lobules of the breast or the area where the milk is formed, and that is called lobular carcinoma of the breast. Or it can be from the connective tissue or the tissue which is holding the breast together, which is called as Phyllot's tumor. There can be a rare entity what is called as angiosarcoma of breast, which arises from the blood vessels of the breast. We'll see little more about these things as we go on. We have been discussing a lot about breast cancer, and now we will be discussing about various types of breast cancer and what are the treatments specific, their characters. Why do we really need to know, or why do we really need to differentiate between these cancers? Now, you will very commonly hear about the ductal carcinoma in situ, or DCIS, and invasive cancer. Now, we will be discussing more about these things, but on a broad sense, DCIS means it is a stage zero cancer, means it is very, very limited to the ducts where it is originating. Whereas invasive cancer means it has gone little bit outside of the, the ducts or the area where it originated. So that is the difference between the two. When it comes to invasive cancer, we further classify them. I mean, there are two types called, ductal carcinoma, where the origin is in the ducts, and there is something called a lobular carcinoma, where the cancer arises from the lobules or the milk producing glands of the breast. So these are the different types of the common cancers. There are other special entities of breast cancer which are called inflammatory breast cancers, where there is a lot of swelling in the breast. When we talk about inflammatory breast cancer, or when we call it inflammatory breast cancer, that means there is a lot of swelling which confuses even the doctors to think that it is a, abscess or an infection rather than cancer. So that difference makes it difficult to diagnose and start the treatment early. So these are very difficult to treat cancers. On the other side, there is also what is called as triple negative breast cancer. Very commonly you hear this terminology, what is called as TNBC, or triple negative breast cancer. These triple negative breast cancers are also a very aggressive type of cancer, but these ones can be treated much better than the inflammatory type of breast cancer. The TNBCs are generally associated with hereditary cancers. So that is a very demarcating feature. So whenever there is triple negative breast cancer, we tend to investigate further to see if there is a genetic cause. There are further rare entities in breast cancer, like what is called as Paget's disease, which starts in the skin of the nipple and the areola of the breast in the form of scabby lesions which are itchy in nature. And these things can progress, and then generally there is an underlying, stage zero cancer in this, and if left alone, they can cause problem. There are other rare entities called Phyllot's tumor. Phyllot's tumor is something which originates from the connective tissue of the breast. We spoke about the ducts, we spoke about the milk forming glands. These are the connective tissues all around the breast. So these connective tissues can also form tumor, and these tumors are called Phyllot's tumor. So these also can be benign as well as malignant. That is, benign means they don't spread anywhere. Malignant means they spread to some other organ. On the other extreme entity, there is an entity called angiosarcoma. Angiosarcoma are the cancers or sarcomas which arise from the blood vessels in the breast. These ones are extremely aggressive, and the treatment for this, even if we do surgery, is not very effective.